In this video, we're going hands-on to craft a mechanical skin for my trusty keyboard, starting from scratch with SolidWorks. After years of focusing on techniques, it's time to apply them in a real-world project. I was so impressed by the precision of a mechanical keyboard that I had to upgrade my old faithful one. Watch as I walk you through each step of this transformation and teach you how to do the same. But let me tell you about my keyboard first. This trusty keyboard has been my partner in crime for years. But lately, I've had an affair with a mechanical keyboard and now I feel like I cannot go back. But I cannot move on from my craft either. So I wanna do a complete overhaul, turn my keyboard into a mechanical one so I can switch back and forth between them. I think it's time. It's time to shift gears, skip the rut, and take control with the DIY keyboard transformation. What I want to do is to design an easily installable mechanical keyboard interface to put on top of this keyboard and enjoy the sound of mechanical keys while I'm at it. I'd like to add another knob on the right to be able to raise or lower the volume with my right hand when I'm working with SolidWorks using my pointing finger like this. How do I do just that? Well, we'll start with the chassis. I 3D print a chassis that sits on this keyboard. It accommodates the mechanical keys to sit on top to press them. But then I realized mechanical keys need switches too, but not like this. They need to be sorted in the right location. Now each keycap should press a unique key on the keyboard below it. So this chassis should have some openings for that. Now each switch should press the key below it, but these switches are closed. They cannot push anything, so I had to fix that. So I'm gonna have to cut everything that exists below this switch and create an opening for it. Now pressing the key would push the pin out of the switch and the pin would press the key on the member keyboard below it, but if I press it too hard, it might damage the keys on my trusty keyboard. So for that, I need to take care of the space between the actual keyboard and the mechanical skin interface. Where should it sit? Well, I could place some points on the logi keyboard, or I could fill all the gaps between the keys and make sure that the interface is fully locked with the keyboard below it, and I chose the latter. So I have to draw these lines. And for that, I have to measure all these lines and dimensions and all that. Or I could work smart for once and instead just measure the width of the keyboard and find an image of the keyboard on the internet and scale that image so that the width of the image is as long as the width of the keyboard. Now the scale is 1:1. At this point, no further measurements are needed, only to double check, and only drawing the lines between the keys, which could take a few minutes or so. It feels so good to reach this level that I think it's time to procrastinate and tell you another story about. Oh wait, I just realized the mechanical keys have different shapes and forms, and the enter key is not quite exactly like the one I have here. And to make the matters worse, the back of each key is not exactly the same. So the location of these openings have to be moved and adjusted. Also, I haven't taken the size and the height of the mechanical switches into account. They need to be fixed on the chassis. So I have to measure the switches and design a box that could accommodate them at the right height sitting above the logi keyboard. Give it an hour and I think I'm there, but how do I know if that works? I don't really feel like modeling these switches in SolidWorks unless I have to. I have 3D printers at home. So I can print a sample, place it on the keyboard, place the switches on the sample, then press a random button. Then it's all good. Life is beautiful again. The first try worked. But we are far from being done. I need to finish the whole thing. Plus that knob thing on the right needs a mechanism to change the volume. And that has to be connected to the chassis too. Plus that chassis is a little bit wobbly. How do I fix that? Let's measure the gaps and thicken these ribs a bit and print another sample and print it again. And it doesn't fit. Fun! So back to the first iteration, remove those ribs and stick to what works. Now we need to come up with a mechanism for the knob. I'm thinking two helical gears. Sounds good? Yeah, sounds good. So let's find out how to make one helical gear set. The dimensions should be roughly about the size of this knob at the 28 millimeters in diameter. Okay, good. First, we must take one and use flex to rotate it at what? Like how much? 90 degrees? Let's search for it. Yes, people say 90 degrees. Okay, let's do that. But wait, why do they interact? Why don't they fit? At what angle do they work? 60? At 60 degrees? But why? It doesn't make any sense. Let's print a sample and see if it works. Yes, it does. At 60. So digging deeper. Okay. The 45 degree should be the angle here. How much you rotate it in SolidWorks depends on the thickness of your gear. Because if I make a gear this thin and rotate it 90 degrees, I get this angle. And if I make the same gear but much thicker and still rotate it 90 degrees, I get this angle. So as long as this angle is 45, I should be okay, and I'm okay, good, moving on. Now this gear is the gear I should be using as an input to increase or lower the volume, and the counterpart should sit vertically next to it to connect to the knob without, of course, being rubbed against my desk. So I cannot go any lower than this. And then I would use a rubber band as the bell to manipulate the actual knob on my keyboard to increase or decrease the volume. Wait, if you're going to install it in one go, what are you gonna do about the belt? I don't want to install the interface and add the belt separately. I want this to be a one-step move, install easily and remove easily. So the belt should be pre-installed. How does one do that? First, I thought I would put a cap around the knob. I would install the belt around that cap, but then I realized I don't have much room here. Luckily, I could model the whole thing in SolidWorks, so I had to look for an alternative solution. Got it! I would put an idler on the left side of the knob, I would put the belt around an idler, and the belt goes around the knob, and through friction, I can increase or decrease the knob, therefore the volume. Good, then I put a ball bearing here. I have one, so I measure it, add that, and boom, ready. Okay, wait, the gear set has to be perfect and working. Otherwise, if I print the chassis and the gears are not working, the whole thing is wasted. It just cost me $130, so I have to be very careful. Therefore, I use the assembly mode in SolidWorks, take a look around, and see if the gears work. Do they? Yes!
Good!
Also, if I rotate the gears down, does it decrease the volume? No? Then change the direction of the helical piece? Works now? Yes? Good! If it already worked, then we keep it that way.
Good.
Do the keys align? I have to print the whole thing and try again? Risk $130 and a couple of weeks of my time?
Yes!
Why? I can just model the key. Add the equation so I can turn one key into all these sizes, assemble the whole thing in SolidWorks, and test it there. Now that I can see the misalignment of the keys, I can move the openings on the chassis to make sure the edge of all keys are aligned. While in the back, they are not aligned. Don't underestimate this. This is important, people. The carpet does not match the drapes.
That was too irrelevant, but I had nothing better to say, so like and share this video just because I said that. Very logical.
Okay, now I rotate the whole model in SolidWorks for the next 2 days straight, and I keep looking at it from different angles, and I keep adding small details to it, like the gaps where the gears are supposed to be sitting on, or the strength of this odd-shaped arm. I added some cuts into it and make it stronger, or at least appeal this way. Oh, that reminds me. Why is there a cap here at all? Why couldn't this red component be just the same part connected to the chassis? Because I would have not been able to assemble these two gears if they did. Because the distance between these two shafts are fixed and I need to be able to easily assemble them. Therefore, this cap has to be removable with a screw. Later on, I realized it was not necessary, but at the time, I took it into account. Let's go online and order this component. Why don't I print it? Because it's too big. So while I wait for the chassis to be printed and arrive here, I'd love to tell you about how I'm able to design these things so easily and so quickly. And you can do the same too with only $38 a year
by going to the 3D Experience SolidWorks for Makers. The maker offer
has taken your number one excuse to start learning SolidWorks away from you. And that's the price. You don't need to pay five digit tens of thousands of dollars anymore. All you have to pay is $48 a year, or using my code below this video, I'm gonna put the link below this video, $38 a year, free tutorials on my channel to learn SolidWorks and your own creativity and motivation. So if you have these three, you can start your journey right now. I'm sure a lot of you are more creative than me and fellow other YouTubers out there. You just haven't started yet. Don't deprive the world from your creativity. If you're a maker, if you consider yourself a creative mind, if you're good, if you're a visual person, go ahead, click on the link,
get your maker offer,
start your SolidWorks journey today. I'm gonna be with you every step of the way. If you have any questions, just comment it, use the links I'm gonna put below this video and every other video on my channel, and become a creator. Unleash the creator inside you and add this skill set to your toolbox, okay? Please. Do yourself that favor and start adding your value to our world. I would love to see your model. I would love to... I place one switch on the keyboard again, slowly, and
they fit. Yes!
But here is something I didn't count on. Two of the switches overlap the left interior wall just a bit too tight, and I noticed two possible breaking lines. To top it all off, I ran out of switches, and the biggest problem is the bending. So I have to order more switches for sure, adjust the position of these two keys and the wall on the left, but the biggest problem is the bending. I could either try to add some ribs here or find a stronger material to print the chassis from, or both, just in case. I just did all of that, and I'm waiting for the new component to arrive. It's here. Then, it's the revealing time to place it on the keyboard. But before that, the rubber band.
Test, test, yo, 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 breaking bad, yo, SolidWorks makers, yo, link. Tap.
Hey, don't you wanna mention about that mechanism you spend weeks on to build? You know, the one that works with the balloon to change the angle of the keyboard? Worth mentioning, man. I mean, you worked on it a lot and it works. It's a good mechanism.
Just to describe you what this is the mechanism that optionally I can install on top of this mechanical skin, make it more sophisticated, and it works with pneumatic system. Two syringes of 5 milliliter is installed inside this. There is a mechanism that works with threads that pushes this, connected to two angioplasty balloons, which are not cheap to buy, but I made them as an R&D project a while ago. When I just turn this wheel, as you can see on my SolidWorks screen as well, this balloon expands and goes to the diameter of 12 millimeters, and this balloon, actually these balloons, because I'm going to use two of them, are going to be used to push the angle of my keyboard up. So how does it work? That's how it goes. It goes in the back like this, and then it goes through this one like that. So this is the first one, this is the second one. Okay. Advantages of, oh shoot, disadvantages of being paying attention, but advantages of being a biomedical engineer. We connect the Y adapters here. Now this is the mechanism you're seeing over there. So this one, this surface over here goes inside and gets screwed to this shaft holder. Over here we have a surface that's designed to sit exactly on top of this shaft over here. Let me just show you, exactly here. And on the inside, we have these two triangles that sit perfectly inside these two triangles, and there is a hole to screw it. And the balloons, of course, go underneath the keyboard. So let me just show you. Screws here. Now it's fully locked, it doesn't move. The quality of this gear is not good printed, but since I'm working with my hand, that's fine. If I wanted to use a different gear, which I already have printed, and use it with the small one, I could, but I'm gonna stick with this one for now. So there are two 5 milliliter syringes inside here, connected to this part, connected to this gear, and when I rotate this gear, it just pushes them both forward at the same time, blowing the balloons to their maximum 12 millimeter diameter, pushing the keyboard 12 millimeter high. So it will give me the angle. This is almost the final look without adding the pneumatic balloons to it. All right, if you watched my video to this level, I thank you very much, and to show my true appreciation, I wanted to talk to you about SolidWorks and how you can start your own journey, because I'm about to give you something for free. When I started working with SolidWorks in 2007, it instantly became my passion, and I found it relaxing and peaceful to sit down behind my computer and just submerge myself into the world of 3D modeling and not thinking about anything else. Watching my thoughts coming out of thin air, getting shapes and forms and colors and functions was something that I found some peace and quiet in, and it took me to the flow state. I have never found anything else ever since that could have the same effect on me. I know a lot of you are already like this. If I'm only talking to one person, you, who can resonate with what I'm saying, it's more than enough for me. After working more than 17 years with SolidWorks, I had to learn everything through trial and error for years, and I put all of that knowledge into a huge package that is golden for a beginner. The sequence it follows, the way I teach it, it just makes sense, and all the reviews support that. But the best part, I have released the first section of my course, the beginner section of that, for free. The link to that is below this video in the description. It's called the mini course, and I'm going to make it even larger than what it is today. Your idea, it's SolidWorks or whatever package, and then manufacturing it real world. So from your head into the real world, all you have to do is the CAD knowledge. If that's what you were looking for, I'm here for you. I will support you every step of the way. I am providing you with free material to start learning. If you don't have the license, I just told you, $38 a year, it takes care of that. You can just click on the link, go sign up, start. I am talking to you, all right? And yeah, that's it. I have the next project being cooked right here. I hope I'll get to see you on my next video soon.